Hi, this is Teresa Richwine. I'm your webmaster, and I'm going to show you in less than 10 minutes how to update your web pages and how to upload and revise documents in the newly upgraded content management system. The first thing you're going to notice is that the URL to login has changed. It is no longer dev.hack.edu/login. It's a little bit longer now. It's auth.hack.commonspotcloud.com/login. You'll get the login window, and I am going to log in using my credentials. You don't need to worry about checking the Open My Commonspot. That gets into more of an approval process, and we're not there quite yet. So I enter my user ID and my password, which has not changed. That has remained the same, and I'm going to click log in. Now by default, it's going to open up the home page, and so far so good. But you're going to notice that we don't have the three grade buttons up here in this upper right corner. What we do have hiding in this corner is a little pencil icon. And if I click that, then it's going to slide out a menu. And you probably won't have all of these options, and that's fine. The only one you really need to have is the work on this page. First, let me go to, I'm going to go to a different page here so I can show you some things. Okay, we're going to pretend I'm an editor for student activities. Go to my page, click the little pencil icon, and I want to work on this page. So now we have a bunch of other stuff that just popped up here in the upper left, and we don't have to worry about with any of that at this point in time. Some of that stuff will come a little bit later. What you really need to notice is that we still have our little cog icon that tells us we have a formatted text block here. And I can click on that, and I still have my text button. I'm going to click on my text button, and up pops the text editor. This interface hasn't changed much at all. You'll still see the same options. You can still go in here and, you know, type and change text just kind of like you're in Word. But what has changed is how you upload new and revised documents. And I could highlight text that's already existing to become a link, but I'm going to type something new, and we're going to upload a new PDF. And please put in parentheses at the end of the link PDF. That way the end user knows that when they click on this link that it's going to be a PDF that opens up. I'm going to highlight the text that's going to be my link, and I'm going to click this little link icon. Now, what has popped up is different than what we've had before. It's the link action tab is clicked by default, and you don't have to worry about these other two. This is the only one we need to concern ourselves with. New type, well, let me look here. What I really want to do is link to a new uploaded document. So I'm going to make sure it's new uploaded document. If you click uploaded document, that will take you to documents that have already been uploaded to the website, and that's something we can get into a little later. For now, we want to link to a new uploaded document. I'm going to select that. Don't have to worry about the subsite destination. That's okay as is. I don't have to worry about the link display. By default, the site-wide style sheets automatically underline any text that's a link, whether it's a link to a PDF or an email or an external website, so don't have to worry about any of that. We'll click Next. And now we're going to see the familiar Browse button. Go to our desktop, and I'm going to select PDF as a test. And for the title, this is really important. You want the title to be as descriptive as possible. You don't want it to be something generic like brochure or application, because if you upload 20 brochures and somebody does a search on the website for brochure, they're going to be a list of 20 that just says brochures, and the end user is not going to have any idea what that brochure is for. So I'm going to give it a descriptive name. Click that little yellow arrow there, and it's going to put the title down in the description. And the keywords is something I encourage you to use. It helps in search engine rankings, not just for our website, but also for external searches like Google. And it gives you a little hint here. You know, it can just be a list of keywords, and they can be fairly generic at this point. And you can actually use combinations of two or three words So we could have golf, comma, tournament, or I could even actually put golf tournament and even 2013 all together. That will work just as well. For these options down here, the publication date and the expiration date and that sort of thing, you don't got to worry about that at this point in time. I'm going to click Save, and what it's going to do at this point, it's going to take that PDF from my PC and it's going to upload it to the server, and it's going to create my links. And now this link goes to my PDF, and down in this little grayed out link field, I can see that it's there. Now I'm happy with it at this point. I have my spell checker on, and I'm going to click Save. And now you'll notice that the little cog icon has changed into the yellow box with the black arrow. Well, that means at this point, I'm the only one that can see this link. It resides only on the author server. So what I need to do is I need to click Submit and push it out to the live web server. And at this point, it doesn't really matter if I hit Submit or if I click Submit Page. The only difference is if I would have a bunch of different elements, or maybe I was working on the nav or something like that, then I would submit page and it would submit all those changes at once. But for now, if we're just working in the text editor, submit sufficient. Nothing's going to happen or blow up if you hit submit page, so don't worry about that. We just want to make sure we don't forget to submit our changes. We're going to have another little box pop up. And we don't have an approval process in effect just yet, so we don't have to worry about that part. But this is a nice little reminder that when you hit submit, your changes are going to get pushed out to the live website, and they are going to be effective, and everybody can see them. So I'm going to hit submit, and it's going to check on a few things. And there we go. It just pushed it out to the live website so everybody in the world can see my link. Now, I just pushed that out a couple minutes ago, and darn, I just saw that I have a typo in it. Now what am I going to do? Well, we're going to log back into our formatted text block. And what we're going to do now, and this is very, very important, that you highlight exactly what is the link now. We don't want to highlight a little bit more, and we don't want to highlight a little bit less. We need to highlight exactly. And if you remember nothing else from this session, remember this part. Highlight exactly what is currently the link. And I'm going to hit my little link icon. And now this looks a little bit different. It's telling me I already have an uploaded document. It's giving me the title, and I know all that, and that's great. But what I really want to do is I want to change the link action. So I'm going to click here. And I have a new dropdown that just appeared. And this is really important because you'll see as one of the options is a new document version. If I had not underlined this exactly, the new document version option would not be displayed. And we don't want to go and upload another new document, because if we upload the same document or even a slightly revised document like two different times, if somebody does a search, both those documents are going to show up on the search, and it's just going to lead to clutter and confusion on the website. So make sure you highlight exactly what the link is. We're going to select new document version. Again, we don't got to worry about the link display. That's taking care of everything. I'm going to hit next, and this is our browse button. I'm going to go in here and select another PDF. I'm going to hit save, and when I hit save, it's going to upload this PDF over top of the old one. So now I'm happy. I have my updated PDF, so I'm going to hit save. And then again, in order for that change to go through, I have to hit submit, or I'm the only one that sees that revised PDF. So again, our changes, they're going to be effective. That's fine. We're happy with that. And there we go. Now the whole world can see my updated link. Now suppose I didn't want to upload a PDF. Suppose I want a link to an external website, let's say like Facebook. I type what I want to be the link. Student Activities has a Facebook page. Let's use that. Student Activities, there's a Facebook page and they want a link to it. Type our text. We select the text we want to be the link. And again, we hit our little link icon. At this point in time, what we want to do is we want to come down here and we want to select unregistered URL or relative internal URL. And what that's going to do, it's going to give us this new little field. And at this point in time, we can type in our Facebook link. And I know if it's going to something specific, it's going to be a lot longer than that, but you can copy and paste the link to your Facebook page right in this field. Again, don't got to worry about the underline. It's going to do that automatically. And we're going to hit save. And just like that, we have a link to Facebook. Now, I don't want that to be there for real, so I'm going to take that away. I'm going to save it. I'm going to submit my change and put the page back to the way it was. Now you know how to edit a page, upload a document, and upload a revised document and link to an external website, which I think is a really good start. As you're working through this, if you end up where you have questions or you'd feel more comfortable having a one-on-one training session, that's fine. Feel free to give me a call or shoot me an email. Here is my contact information, and you can also contact Ken Norton as well. He's the web programmer. He's just as good with all this stuff as what I am. So good luck and happy web page editing.